What does it feel like if you have the COVID-19?
You know, to a large extent, COVID-19 is a respiratory illness. So most patients will have very mild disease, typically fever, cough. Sometimes they may have shortness of breath, which typically may imply a more significant process. Some patients may have diarrhea or other symptoms related to involvement elsewhere, but primarily it's a respiratory disease.
You mentioned shortness of breath. What does that really mean? Is there a test for that? Is it how long I can hold my breath?
So shortness of breath is a subjective symptom where the patient feels that they can't get enough air. That typically is what we refer to as being short of breath.
Because I've seen some places where it's like, well, if you can take 4 deep breaths in a minute or whatever, is there any sort of...
No, there's no specific guideline or test that can tell you whether you're short of breath. It's really a subjective symptom.
If you just feel like you're having trouble breathing?
Absolutely, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Should we be going to the gym? Should we be going to the grocery store? Should we be going out and about right now?
So right now we're recommending that... We take common sense measures. There's some benefit to social distancing. So perhaps, you know, avoiding unnecessary handshakes, covering your cough, making sure that when you sneeze or cough, you know, you either cough into your elbows or use a tissue and make sure you dispose of that tissue. Washing your hands frequently and doing it the right way, which typically involves doing your hand washing for at least 20 seconds or using an alcohol-based hand sanitizer that has over 60% alcohol in it. In terms of where to go, I think, again, common sense should dictate that. We're really, at this point, recommending that people avoid very large gatherings, typically over 50 to 100 people, and just avoiding being in crowded places where you can't be sure in terms of how often the door handles are cleaned and those kinds of things.
How does this feel different than, say, the flu or a cold?
That's a great question. The COVID-19 and influenza are very similar in terms of their presentation, so it may be very difficult to tell them apart. Same with the common cold or other coronaviruses that cause respiratory illness. Most patients will have mild disease, but the spectrum of presentations is essentially the same. So the only way to actually tell whether you have COVID-19 is through the test.
When do I need to get tested?
Our recommendation at this time is that if you're not feeling well, stay home. Call your primary care physician and speak to him or her to get some guidance and advice in terms of what you should be doing.
What is most of that advice right now?
Yes.
If I'm 100.3 temperature, I took myself, I've got a cough, I've got a little shortness of breath, but I seem to be breathing okay.
If you're breathing okay and otherwise feeling okay, we recommend that you stay home. Drink lots of fluids, take analgesics like you would with any other upper respiratory illness. If you begin to get worse, we recommend that you call your primary care provider and get some advice in terms of what the next step should be. We do not recommend that you show up at the emergency department without calling or without getting that initial guidance, because this helps protect others as well at those sites.
So if my doctor tells me to go to the emergency room, what can I expect when I get there?
If your doctor has enough suspicion based on the screening tests or screening questions to suggest that you may have COVID-19, your physician or advanced practice clinician will call the emergency department so that they're prepared for you. The same happens if you call the emergency medical services. They will come prepared to put on a mask to make sure that you are appropriately protected and protecting others before you get to the emergency department. The emergency departments have a set of processes that they will follow to make sure that others who work in that particular area and other patients are protected. They will do the testing in a particular environment that is away from the rest of our patients.
And another big concern people have, sort of long term or longer term, larger scale, is the hospital beds, the breathing machines, those types of things that may be needed. What is being done, or can you do at this point?
So this is an evolving situation, and it's very difficult to say exactly the scope of what we're likely to see in the city of Milwaukee. We feel that we are prepared based on our assessment of our resources, but this is an evolving situation, so we'll address those challenges as we move forward.
How is it that children or young adults don't seem to be as affected as the elderly population and the severity of the symptoms?
Yes, we don't know enough about this disease in terms of why children tend to do better. There are many theories out there, but no one knows for sure. We do know that the elderly are clearly more susceptible to more severe disease and death as a result of that, and especially in those who have other comorbidities or other conditions like heart disease, lung disease, and the like. But we don't know enough to say why some populations tend to do better than others at this time.
Getting back to the question about whether someone has it or not, let's say their symptoms are mild, they call in. I mean, is it necessary that they be tested at this point, or can they just self isolate and ride it out, and if it doesn't get worse, they'll never know whether they had it or not? Is that important to know right now?
So that's a great question, and we don't have a good answer to that either. Our understanding of the disease process currently suggests that a lot of people who get the disease have very mild disease and may not even know that they have it. There is always that risk of transmission, even with a mild disease. But if a person is doing okay, we feel that the best thing to do is actually just stay home and make sure that you're protecting yourself and other members of your family.
Right. Let me just double check here. What's the testing like? How long does that take? What does it involve?
So the current test is actually a very quick procedure where we swab through the nose as well as through the mouth to make sure that we get the right specimen. Sometimes if the person has a significant cough and they're coughing up sputum, we may also send that for testing. So it's a relatively quick test, and there are a lot of centers that have gone to drive-through testing as a result of that, but it's a test that should take no more than a few minutes.
And how long does it take to get the results?
So the initial turnaround times for many of our labs were in the range of 72 hours. That's getting better as we speak, but there's still some improvement needed in terms of turnaround times.
And are all those tests right now being done at a government level, or are you able to do those tests?
So at the moment, all the tests are still done at the government level. We anticipate that by the end of this month, many of our labs will be able to carry out the tests as well.
Last question for you. We talk about having things on hand in case you have to be at home for 2 weeks or that kind of thing. Medicine-wise, are there things that I would want to have at home? I know we're not able to buy antivirals over the counter, but are there things that you can have that, we just ask you the question, what things should I have medically at home right now?
So just like we do for most viral illnesses, we tend to treat the symptoms because for most of those viruses, we don't have an effective drug. The same is true of COVID-19. At the moment, there are no approved antiviral agents that are available for use. And so we recommend for those who are staying home to do the simple measures of drinking lots of fluids, getting lots of rest, protecting yourself as well as others in the house, taking analgesics as you may need. And if you begin to get worse, then make sure you call your healthcare provider.
But analgesics, so Advil or?
Acetaminophen, ibuprofen. Again, sticking to the recommendations on each of those medications.
And good idea to have a thermometer just to help you kind of to tell whether you have a fever or not, right?
Absolutely. Having a thermometer certainly wouldn't hurt.
Yes. Okay. Anything you wanted to say that I didn't get to?
Again, we continue to emphasize common sense measures, just making sure that you wash your hands often and stay home when you're not feeling well.
You guys feel ready for this?
We absolutely feel ready. And we try to plan for contingencies as we see the illness begin to increase in our community. We will ramp up our efforts as well.
Is this something you envisioned in your planning?
You know, we always plan for all sorts of things. And that's part of what we do in any hospital. And we never know what we're going to expect, but we try to anticipate them based on our understanding of the community we live in, as well as the potential for disease outbreaks.
And you've anticipated something along these lines, at least.
Absolutely. Luckily, we've also had experience from previous illnesses, and so we plan based on what those experiences have taught us.